Welcome to this quick guide where I'm going to show you how to clone your hard drive or SSD with the AOMEI Partition Assistant. And if you get any value out of this video, please click the like button and subscribe to the channel. But to get started with the guide, now if we go ahead and click on clone up here, we have a few different options, and we can either migrate an OS, which will only clone the system and boot partition to an SSD or another hard drive. Or you can clone the entire disk to another disk, including the system boot files, or you can choose to only clone a partition to another disk. Now, in most cases these days, people are replacing their old hard drives with SSDs, so they'll be using the clone disk function, and if I go ahead and click on this, you'll see that I have two options. I can either clone the disk quickly or do a sector by sector clone. Usually, I also recommend that you just use this first option, and you can go ahead and click on next. And then you'll need to select the source disk. So this means you need to select the disk that Windows is currently installed on. And for me, it's disk 2, which is the Western Digital SSD that I have installed. So once you've identified your source disk, you can select it and then click on next. Then you need to choose a destination disk. So if you're replacing your hard drive with an SSD, this is where you'll need to select your SSD. So this is the blank disk that you have, or this is the target disk that you have where you need to clone the drives to. So in this example, I'll just go ahead and select disk 3, which is the external hard drive that I have plugged into this machine. Now it's very important to note that all of the contents on this target disk will be deleted in the process of cloning this data. And you can also optimize the performance of the SSD if the destination disk is an SSD. So only if you're cloning to an SSD, you need to select this option here. And then you can go ahead and click on next. Once again, like I explained before, all of the data on this destination disk that you're cloning to will be completely wiped out. If you're sure that you want to do this, you can go ahead and click on yes. Now next, you're going to have some different cloning options. You can clone the disk without resizing the partitions. You can fit the partitions to the entire disk, or you can edit the partitions on this disk yourself. Now to edit these partitions, you can select a partition and then you can click on this slider here to drag this partition smaller or larger. Now for these system partitions, I don't recommend that you change the size of it at all. You can just leave it as is. You only need to change the size of your data partition or your local disk partition. Now, if I choose this clone without resizing partitions option, because I'm cloning from a 500 gig to a terabyte drive, you'll see that I have a bunch of unallocated space here. And ideally, you'd want to have all of those unallocated space allocated to this local disk drive. And if you select this fit partitions to entire disk option here, it's automatically going to allocate all of that free space to this local disk. So to go ahead with this clone, you can just click on next. And before starting, you'll see a note that after the clone or migration, all the destination disks will be bootable, meaning you'll be able to boot from it. But there are a few cases where some computers just aren't able to boot from the destination disk. And then they give you some tips on how to troubleshoot that issue. Now, that's a topic for a whole nother video that I'll create on this channel. I'm not going to be explaining that in this video. But once you're ready to start the clone, you can just go ahead and click on finish. And then to actually start the clone, you'll have to click on apply so you can apply those actions. Now cloning this disk is going to take a whole lot of time, so I'm not going to apply the action in this video. I've already showed you what it looks like when you apply these actions, and I'll create another tutorial on this channel showing you exactly how you can migrate your operating system to an SSD and clone your existing drive to an SSD. So I hope this guide's been useful. Please like the video, and I'll talk to you soon.